Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over what to do with responses once you receive them from a survey or a quiz in Microsoft Forms. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So I've gone to www.office.com and I've clicked on Forms over here. If you can't find it over here, it should be under the apps right here. And so what I would like to do right now is go over a sample test that we've already gone over. So I'm going to go down here to sample test and just click on it. And I sent this out in an earlier lesson that we did in the last couple weeks. And right now I have collected 8 responses. So this is what I would like to look at during this video. So if I click on responses, I get some metrics here. So let's just go over some of the metrics that I can see on my screen. I can see the average time that it took people to complete. I can see that it is still active. And what that means is if I click on these 3 dots up here and I go down to settings, this flag is turned on where I'm still accepting responses. Or I could have put a start date and an end date. And if the time right now falls in between the start date and the end date, it will still show as active. I can also see here and up here that I have had 8 responses. So let's go over this dashboard a little bit. First, I get a pie chart of how my questions were answered by the people who took my quiz. So I can see that 63% thought the Civil War started in 1860. A quarter of my respondents gave the right answer of 1861, and then another respondent, making up 13%, said that it was in 1865. And if I click on more details right here, I can see the different answers for the people who took my quiz. In this case, I didn't require my students to log in, but you could have done that and gotten a different name right here. And I can see the same information for the second question and the third question. Also, when I go to post scores, I'm able to post this so that everyone can see what their scores were for their quiz. I can also go to review answers right here. And I can go quiz by person right up here by clicking this arrow right here. And right here is their test score. So I can go through and see this person got a 33, this person got a 0. And overall, I can tell, besides respondent number 7, that most people did not do very well on my quiz. I can also click here and go to questions and see a summary of how each of the questions were answered. So this answer was by 5 respondents. This correct answer was by 2. And this response right here was by 1. So I can see them by people. And I can also see them by the question itself. I also have the option to click this button right here and download an Excel file. When I open up that Excel file, I can see that my responses have been downloaded and I can do some further analysis inside of Microsoft Excel. If I click these 3 dots right here, I can delete all the responses, and I might want to do this if I wanted to send this quiz out again for, say, another class that I might have. I can print a summary, which is a summary of the information that you have seen below. So if I click on that, you can see it's a report of the graphs that we just went over. And finally, I can share a summary link if other people would like to see the results of this quiz. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So I'm going to go back to Forms right here, and I'm going to click here on my customer feedback survey. So this one's going to be a little bit different because it's not quiz results, but it is a survey result. So when I click on responses here, I can see that 3 people have responded. And this is very similar to my quiz responses. I can see that this is still active. On average, it took 15 seconds for my respondents to complete, and I have 3 responses. So here I can see a breakdown of which products were purchased. And if I click more details, I will see who responded with that response. But usually surveys are anonymous, so sometimes you can't see who actually gave you that response. So in this case, the numbers become a little bit more important. And on my second question, I can see the latest responses. So I can see 12, someone else wrote 12 ounces, so those are very similar. And when I click on more details, I can see the actual numbers that were input. And then I can see my ratings here, and I have an overall good rating. And I can also see when people visited and how likely my survey respondents are to recommend us to a friend or colleague. So just like with my quiz, I can go up here and I can delete all my responses if I want to send out the survey again. I can print the summary below, and I can also share the summary below. And I can also open in Excel and click on the file that was downloaded. And I can further analyze the results from my survey within Microsoft Excel. And the really nice thing that I would like to mention about using Microsoft Forms and Excel together, if you're using a business account of office.com, not the personal one or the home one, but a business one, then these results can update automatically every time someone does an entry inside of a Microsoft form that you've created within Excel. So that's really exciting because you don't have to keep downloading the results. They just update in real time. So hopefully that gives you a quick overview on how to download and process results from either a quiz or a survey that you've done in Microsoft Forms. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.